Hi everyone, Alfred here from Alfred.tv, and it's January 6th, 2015. It's a beautiful, brisk day here in lovely Las Vegas. Now, when you think of Las Vegas, you think of things like gambling, women, alcohol, drugs, shows, partying. Am I here for that? I say, nay, nay. No, I'm here for this, the Consumer Electronics Show. Yes, the Consumer Electronics Show, where we can see all the latest electronic toys that keep us in our home, that keep us sedentary, that keep us overweight, that totally pollute the planet and fill the landfills. Couldn't think of a better thing to do today. Nice. Let's go check it out. So I just walked onto the trade show floor, and my first experience was that someone was throwing balls at my face. Yes, orange balls, B-A-W-L-S. So from a Skyworth, we have a 4K curved OLED TV. Yes, the TVs are indeed curved. I guess it's good if you have scoliosis. You see, look at this. Even at CES, there are indeed cable mismanagement systems on the trade show floor. Looked almost as messy as my cables back to the house. We have this lovely lineup of these ultimate massage chairs that guarantee a happy ending when it's done. Oh, I really like this. A company called Bliss Lights, and they have products you put into your home to like vomit lasers all over the wall. Take a look. Guaranteed to give you an epileptic seizure. So I saw a big Panasonic banner, and I was very excited to see the Panasonic Lumix camera, but to my surprise, they're also showing happy ending massage chairs. This is like a hot new thing here. I'm at the Unic booth. They have their SUX 9000 drone. This is great for like spying on your neighbors. Oh, but here's their H920 version. This truly is their FF class model. It looks like carbon fiber. I mean, hell, you can drop some bombs out of this freaking thing. I like it. Very impressive controller on this thing. And this can be used for, like, urban assault. I want two, please. Well, I'm here at the Oculus booth, and let me tell you something about all this virtual reality goggles. It failed miserably many times. We'll see if this thing pukes anything out that's good. So here we have the future of video gaming. This person is using an Oculus headset and some type of an interactive pad here. And if you take it out of context, it looks kind of ridiculous. And yeah, this puts a whole new spin on teabagging someone after you shoot them with a first-person shooter type of game. I don't know, I'm not impressed. Okay, so the guy is running around on that sensor pad with the Oculus headset. I don't know, if I'm playing a video game, I want to be sitting on my sofa, relaxing and mashing buttons. I don't want to be like strapped into a device. It's ridiculous. And no, it's not exercise, because if you're not sweating, it's not exercise. And David just video-bombed me, the bastard.
I did, successfully.
This is a real pretty lineup of rodential input devices. Really, these are pretty. So here we have Ecovax Robotics. And I can indeed say that these robots suck. Let me show you. Yes, these robots suck because they're vacuums. I like that one too. Here we have a demonstration of drones. More drones for urban assault activities. So here we are, Stern Pinball. You know, I'm a big fan of pinball, and Stern is one of the few companies that's still cranking out machines. We got Star Trek. And Mustang. Look at that, a Walking Dead machine. And WrestleMania. A little close-up view of the play field here on Star Trek. It's a real nice-looking machine. And here's the Walking Dead machine. Let's do a quick pan shot here. Beautiful. This is the DXR racer chair. These are really nice. These are really nice. And the model is very hot too, you know, but this is a nice nice office chair, gaming chair, FF mode, nice. I'll take two on these too. Yes, at CES we have more drones. Notice that hot pink. Wow, more urban assault vehicles. But these drones are definitely hot items at CES. I like this, light grooves, intelligent visible cable. Let me press the button. Yeah, they're gonna use these on catheters in the hospital. Brilliant. So over here they're showing a new technology back massager. I don't know, it seems a little bulky. Probably hurt you more than help you. So I'm here at the O-Box booth, and they're showing off their own console, which is gonna launch next year with more independent type games. And a bold move, man. They're going after like what Xbox and PS4 is not addressing, those more smaller independent games. We'll see how they do. And the definition of fleet management. It helps you manage enemas. And here are some really nice sealing devices. These are very useful when you buy something at Walmart, like a PS4. Take the PS4 out, put in bricks, and then you reseal it. Okay, and what's the joke about the Garmin booth? Garmin, that makes GPS systems. I had a lot of trouble finding the booth. Yeah, TP-Link for a networking toilet paper, very relevant. Without any doubt, this is the second largest roving webcam I've seen today. That thing is fucking huge! Wow, I like this. Mercury Innovations is showing a portable dirt box. So you load up dirt and some water, and then whenever you want to look like dirty or whenever you want to look like you've done something really physically challenging, you press a button and it vomits dirt all over your body. There you have it. These are like annoying things that they're going to put into urinals or something like that. So hot new stuff at Razer. That's their version of like an Apple TV type device that will also play games. And they got this new keyboard where the pad folds out, but the mouse sticks magnetically to the pad. And basically, I know a lot of people that do things with their mouse that makes it stick to the mouse pad, so I'm not that impressed. And they have a nice keyboard for epileptics. So I'm here at NVIDIA, and they're showing off this beautiful Viper, which is quite lovely. And the Viper has the Renovo Coupe Digital Cockpit. So there you have it. Let's go in there. Such great Alfred.tv cinematography here for my fine viewers. Yeah, correction. It's a Shelby Cobra, all right? It's a Shelby Cobra, but like most things on this channel and at Alfred.tv, there's plenty of misinformation, but actually we corrected it. What the hell, NVIDIA, autopilot and cock. Oh, it's a cockpit. Gene, I wonder if CNET is here. Well, they're right in back of me. I couldn't keep a straight face much longer. And this is a really nice urban assault vehicle at the Midland booth called the Rally Fighter. I want one of these. This thing is just incredible. I'm giving you an Alfred.tv reach around, pan shot, walk around. Yeah, whatever. Something like that. Here we go. This thing is cool. I have no idea what it is, but yeah. Let's see inside. Yeah, this is neat. Oh, David DeFranco, the creative one. So funny bumping into you here and doing a slow pan shot at how you're equipped. I do see that you have quite a bit of bags there, all right? And that means I will make, you damn tall. I will make sure to get some tea. So you can
really?
Be, yeah, oh. So you can be teabagged. You missed that joke?
No, I was going to say, I don't feel like tea, it's hot.
You just missed that whole joke, you blew that joke. Wow. I'm at the Kabassi booth, and they have a very bold design in speakers. Very very interesting looking. I like these. I guess I would say I'd take two, because then it would be proper stereo. So at ZTE, and I've never heard of them, you have to grab a basketball, run across the floor, jump onto the trampoline, and then try to make a basket. I tried it, and I did it, but we forgot to record it, so I just want to document that. Ah, the DivX booth. Yes, the format that delivers your torrented porn in beautiful 4K. I'm at the Playbulb booth, and they got really cool light bulbs. Again, we like things that light up, I really do. Nice light up digital candles. And more things to make your home look like a techno rave. Nice. Now this is interesting. Vino has a booth, I guess, for anti-flatulence. Oh, it's a Q. I thought it was an O. But look, it's in the shape of a freaking bean. I thought it was Beano. If it was Beano, that would be like the fart booth. And more of these pod chairs. This is really very interesting.
I mean, if you get one of those chairs, you might never leave it. It's like being in the womb.
So here we're showing the Apple Watch, and this is one of the iOS skins for it. I don't really like it. Well, we're at the Kodak booth.
Will it piss them off if I ask them about processing my roll of Kodachrome film? Probably.
Well, here is the S-Frame PC case. And this is an award-winning case. And this is quite interesting looking with its water cooling system. And this particular case will like recycle urine. It uses a catheter and it keeps your CPU nice and cool. Beautiful. So like fish, we're swimming upstream to brave the crowds to get out of the South Hall. With salmon, yeah, we are salmon. So Samsung took like a bunch of iPads and strung them together to make a big booth. I'm lying.
Well, Panasonic is showing an ultra, 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 ultra wide home theater television. Let me show you. I'm gonna give you a Alfred.TV slow pan shot.
Ah, look at the size of this TV set. This is one wide set.
We're living in extraordinary times.
All right, here's the signs for the Wetzel dog. I don't know, that looks pretty nasty. Wow, that is the second largest 110-inch 4K TV I saw today. Well, here's the Chang Hung booth, and it's definitely decorated like a buffet. Which I like buffets, I'm not gonna lie.
Well, I'm at the Intel booth. It's really quite impressive, but what I really like about Intel, what I really like about the company,
is that they spent the money for the extra plush carpet. Very nice.
So you're in this blue battle star, so lower your hand a little bit. Lower. That's you. So a little left. Right. Go up. Good. Got it? Okay. Now, that's just tracking his movement of his arm. This thing will also track your gestures. So I want you to close your fist. And it fires. So hold it. Hold your fist. Yeah, just hold it. And you'll fire all the time. If you release the fist, it stops firing. Now, two fingers. Shoots a missile. So not only does it track your movement, but it tracks his gesture. It looks at his fingers, it looks at his knuckles, it looks at his joints, it creates that in the 3D and knows exactly what he's doing, and that engages the weapon system on this particular game. Good job. Well done.
This has amazing applications for interactive porn. There's a cool wall at Intel. It kind of tracks you. See, I'm like moving my arm. Boy, this is like going to be like good for like a techno rave. I'm very, very impressive. I feel like I'm magical. Or, listen,
you can get the same effect if you do a lot of drugs.
Watch the depth of this. And then I'm gonna put something in front to give it depth.
Demonstrating the sand wall. So let's, I'm interacting with this wall now. Again, this stuff is good for parties, I guess. Or a club. Or a bar. Okay, at Intel, we're showing the latest in wearable technology. What does it do?
What does it do?
Yes.
Right now it's in a mode that she can sense when people get close to her, and when you get too close...
Wow, so that's going to make it very difficult to approach this very attractive woman on the dance floor. She doesn't have to say, I don't want to dance with you, like, just get the hell away. I like it.
Exactly. And it's got another mode where she can do it just by her breathing.
Right. Nice. Beautiful.
She can control that with a deep
breath. Actually very fashionable. A little bit of Geiger in there, too, you know? Very, very nice. Very nice.
It's all 3D printed as well.
If that was 3D printed?
Yep.
Wow, that's really impressive.
Selective laser sintering, and it's like a nylon material.
Yeah, amazing. Amazing. Thank you. Got a nice line of...
has got a quiet three, but he also got a quiet
very compact systems. That one from Gigabyte has an i7 in it. Very nice. I like this, an SD card RAID array. The mighty, mighty Adam B did it years ago with thumb drives. And more drones. Boy, these drones are all over the place. As such, there is no more privacy. Get over it. Boy, now this is an awesome trio of curved TVs. This would be great when I go back to editing video with iMovie HD 2006. I can really get the full width of the crap I'm editing. Here's a nice Steadicam mount. And they have a mount coming out, so you can have the iPhone on it, which is really nice. It's the Steadicam smoothie. My only problem is that my viewing audience is used to really shaky, crappy footage, so I can't use something like that. I'd have to put the shake in with post-production. At the Nikon booth, they're doing free three-dimensional MRI imaging and doing prostate cancer screening, which I think is a nice thing at the show. Very nice. Thank you, Nikon. So here's the array of Nikon cameras that did that wonderful imaging. And what's really cool is that every one of these cameras controlled and sequenced by an Apple II. And now I'm going to show you why North Korea hates South Korea. Samsung. Look at the size of this company. Holy cow. And that's David DeFranco. Here's the Galaxy Note Edge. I mean, the screen is really beautiful. I guess if you're using the Edge, you're edging, I guess. Whatever. Here is Samsung's gig on innovative speaker design. And here we see them hanging from the ceiling like alien pods. Well, that kind of looks like an alien pod as well. Like, open up like aliens. Blah. I'm at the TiVo booth and they're showing Big is the New Small, and there we have a 24 terabyte TiVo system. 24 terabytes. And of course the punchline is, it's a hell of a lot of porn on that thing. Well, here at the Panasonic booth, this is without any doubt the second largest pair of headphones I've seen today. Here's a new 4K camera coming out from Panasonic. But what's really cool is they have an ancillary camera, so you can do like picture-in-picture while you have the main video feed, which is 4K. That's not 4K, but here you see me picture-in-picture with my Sanyo Exacti. This is coming out later this year, but this is pretty hot. And here's Panasonic's Lumix DSLR. I don't want to bust it. And it has a dead cat on top. But this does 4K video, and I hear a lot of people are very, very excited about this camera. I might check it out. And the model of this camera is the Lumix GH4 DSLR, which films in 4K with autofocus. Very nice. And at the core of this very tricked out rig is that same Lumix G4 camera. That is really very cool. I can make some really good videos with this thing. Panasonic showing their 4K colonoscopy cameras, though that would be probably pretty big to stick in your rectum. Rectum damn near killed them. Dave is laughing at the rectum nearly killed them line. Dave, you shouldn't laugh at this stuff. The jokes are old and they stink.
I get it. Stink, rectum.
Oh, I made a nested joke. Nice.
Really? You didn't mean to do that?
No.
Nice.
Really?
That's even better.
And I see that AOL is here. I see these AOL signs. And AOL is doing something new. They're doing analog chat rooms. That's what they're demonstrating here. They're grouping people together and they're talking face to face. Nice. And yes, at CES we do have strippers. Just waiting for her to take it off. This is certainly overwhelming at Samsung. Yes, very nice. An Alfred.tv slow pan shot. Of course, I film it when there's nothing on the feed, whatever. Canon is rolling out a new series of lens specifically aimed at marketing to stalkers. So yeah, so if you're a stalker, that's the type of lens you want to get. That's an FF class lens. You see, this is the exact same camera system I use for my Alfred.tv videos. I mean, rarely do you see me filming it, but there it is, folks. Dave is showing the first swag he absconded with from the Clips booth. How do you say Clips? What do you got, Dave?
I have bullshit.
You have bullshit? Another,
I don't know if you can see that.
If you look up bullshit in the thesaurus, it will come like the word poppycock means the same thing.
Yes.
It does, really. There you have it. Bolshevik. It's good to see that Canon is getting into dentistry, because they're now offering a fluorine coating for your teeth, which is lovely. Canon's showing off some interesting cutaways of the lens. If this was like an artery, like my artery, it would have been loaded with cholesterol based on the buffet. I'm at the Sony booth, and look, I'm shooting in 4K. Wow, that joke sucked. And here's a quick official Alfred.tv 360 slow pan shot in the Sony booth, and it's quite overwhelming. And they're showing, like, you know, everything here. What the hell, dude? Cameras, phones, video cameras, PS4 gaming systems, and yeah. And we have with DeFranco. Well, there it is. Sony has a 4K consumer video camera. It has a floating head technology, so the image stays nice and stable. It's going to come out in April. It's going to be under $1,000. An image so stable that the camera shake that you're used to will have to be put in post. So here's a little better view of that new Sony 4K camera. And if you see, the lens is like on a, is it a gimbal, John? What do you call it?
Exactly.
So the lens is actually housed in a gimbal. So as you're moving the camera, the lens stays relatively stable. So there you have 4K video, consumer video, for under $1,000 price point. This is really very exciting.
So Alfred, if you get that 4K camera, will you shoot in 4K?
No, Dave. I'll knock it down to 720p so I have the, so I can deliver the proper quality that my audience is used to.
Nice.
Here's a 75-inch FF class 4K TV. And the Alpha TV review is that, without any doubt, wow, this thing is really thin. I mean, it really is thin. Look at that. Sony getting the Walkman brand out of the closet with a high-definition audio player. This is really quite beautiful. So that was their high-end model at a $1,000 price point. Here's the more consumer-grade unit. Very nice. Of course, the resurgence of a vinyl. We do an Alfred.tv pan shot of some of the vinyl releases or re-releases from the Sony catalog. And it's nice to see. It's really beautiful, the format. Of course, as long as you can get, you know, you're okay with the pops and clicks. I didn't know that Seth came out with a holiday Christmas album. I gotta get that. So Sony has a high-power home audio room right there. I don't know, everyone that came out of the room, their like ears were like bleeding. Okay, so here's a riddle for you. What does Polaroid and zombies both have in common? They're the Walking Dead. Did you ever think you'd see a smartphone from Polaroid? So they're really
quad-core 3G, but it says dual-core down here.
So they're really expanding their product line here. So Polaroid is showing off their Cube Cam, a small little video camera. I'm trying to look at the specs, and I was going to make a dust joke. It records HD at 1080p. High capacity battery, can record up to 90 minutes. This can be a very, very useful spy cam. Put one or two in the bathroom somewhere. So they do have a suite of accessories, including a waterproof enclosure for it. And this is referring to this as a football. You can put the camera in there and throw this thing like a bomb. That could get some really interesting footage, especially if you hit someone in the head with it. So here is a new Polaroid camera, and this one has a built-in printer. So I guess this is like the modern digital iteration of the the Polaroid Land camera. Land is in L-A-N-D, Land camera. this is, you know, this isn't fitting in your pocket, but it does have a printer. You're not sneaking this one into the strip club, I'm sorry. So it's vomiting out a picture of me. Boy, it really did vomit it out.
It did.
Yeah, and there's the size compared to my thumb, and compared to a Mountain
caught
Dew.
It.
David almost dropped the thing and busted it.
Well, he dropped his, but I caught mine.
Doing a drop test.
They don't melt very well.
We can do a drop test here. So there you go. Color it loud, but they spelled it wrong. And I'm here at the very, very, very impressive and very large booth, the Monster Booth, CES 2015. And do you know how they built this very impressive booth, this very costly booth? By selling HDMI cables for $150 freaking dollars. Wow. So I'm here at the GoPro booth and their logo is Be a Hero. I don't know why I would want to be a deli sandwich. Yeah, so I think the theme for GoPro should be buy a GoPro and film yourself getting hurt doing really stupid things that are way beyond your physical capability. And I'm not even going to make the joke. LG has a pretty big booth. Little known fact though, LG used to be Gold Star. LG is sewing OLED TVs with crystals from Swarovski. There you go. LG is showing their new SUX 9000 intelligent washing machine. I guess it's internet enabled, and if it senses too much dirt on the underwear, it orders you a new pair. Yeah, so we got LG gaming monitors powered by their free stink technology. Here's LG's new ultralight notebooks. And they're thin, they run Windows. Lots of slim, curved 4K TVs here at the LG booth. Official LG logo. Very nice. FF class vehicle here. Look at this. And nice eye candy at the show. Beautiful. Wow, and this is one FF class Cadillac Eldorado. Look at the length of this car. I mean, Jesus H. Christ, that's a huge machine. Here's a model of a Mercedes, prototype future car, autonomous, self-driving, blah, blah, blah. And I don't know, if it has a Mr. Fusion and if it can fly, that would be really, really impressive. But this is their concept of the lines that we'll be seeing in automotive technology in the future. And this is a quite lovely Mercedes. And the logo on the side of the car, it says like V8-bit turbo. I like that. A nice car. I'll take two. We have the beautiful Corvette ZR1. I'm not really a fan of this color. This burnt orange. But it's certainly a beautiful vehicle as we do the official Alfred.TV. Walk around, reach around, excuse me, in front of me. And there you have it, Corvette Z06. Look at fine Alfred.TV cinematography as we do a nice slow pan up the nose of the car and whatever. There it is. Nice machine. I'll take two of these too. Well, I'm at the Audi booth and they're giving a little sneak preview of their self-driving cars. And here's a pan shot of the prototype of self-driving car. Again, beautiful lines. And this will be really interesting if this thing fully comes to fruition. Rear shot of the self-driving prototype. I don't know if I want a self-driving car. I like driving. Why remove that from me? Yeah. More cool cars at the JVC booth. Not a fan of the color, but I love the gull wing doors, whatever, the flip-up doors. Well, this is an interesting vehicle called the Slingshot. Kind of reminds you of the T-Rex a little bit. Oh, the animal rights activists are not gonna like this. So Griffin actually has a video camera that you, I guess, surgically implant into the ear of your pet. I don't know if that's gonna go over too good. At this booth, they're showing a demonstration of how the MacBook Air can be used as an ancillary heating device, putting on these coals. which are then fired up and the machine melts and creates heat. Well, here I am, day three at CES, and I'm back again at the Griffin booth. And Griffin today introduced the new Bluetooth breast speakers for the Bluetooth compliant breast implants. I think this is really a brilliant product. Well, I guess the folks at Power Bass are showing some new high-tech fishing equipment. Oh, my bad. It's speakers. Yes, less charging. Use cash. Oh, the Fahrenheit company is here showing their new line of digital rectal thermometers. I guess they would truly be digital. Well, Toyota is here. Maybe I can hunt down one of the senior executives and complain about how my Toyota Venza had unintended acceleration in reverse. Well, they're showing us some type of an intelligent wireless charging station. Well, I guess it makes sense why my iPhone 6 Plus went from 40% all the way up to 100 while I'm standing at the freaking booth. Audio Pipe just rolled out a new form of e-cigarette, a pipe with a subwoofer in it. All right, and this company has a service to give you a maximum ticket protection from an escort. Hell, if I was in Vegas with an escort, I'd want maximum disease protection. And the fine folks at TRW are showcasing cognitive safety systems. Now, from that particular tagline, I would assume they're selling crash helmets. You know, cognitive, protect your brain. Okay, we're rolling footage of the great John Rettinger. And John, I scripted a bad joke specifically with you and your company in mind. Okay, you ready?
Let's do it.
All right, it's a riddle. All right, if you're hosting a party, all right, what hamburger meat can you serve at both an EDM, an electronic dance music party, and a rave? Answer?
Techno Buffalo.
And there you have it, John. Good seeing you, buddy.
Good seeing you, man. Watch this guy. Subscribe to this guy. He's a living legend right here.
Don't. The content really sucks.
Welcome to Alfred.TV.